Namaste. Myself, Dr. Richa Chauhan, working as assistant professor in Banasthali Vidyapith, Faculty of Management. Training focuses on doing activities 2 days for to develop employees for their current jobs and development in preparing employees for future roles and responsibilities. There are many in-depth concepts which need to be discussed in detail. For that, we have Professor Anil Mehta with us. Sir, please tell me something about yourself and throw some light on this topic.
Hello, everyone. I am Professor Anil Mehta. I was professor and head in the Department of Business Administration, University of Rajasthan, Jaipur. And my area of specialization was HR as well as training. And I am engaged and very actively associated with number of professional organizations, including ISTD, HRD Network, NIPM, etc. And also conducted quite a large number of training programs for corporate sector as well as for the academic institutions.
Please show some light regarding training and development. Like, this video is about training and development.
There is a Chinese proverb. Give a child a fish, he will eat a day. But teach him how to fish, he will eat every day. And another proverb is that if you are planning for just 1 year, sow seeds. If you are planning for 10 years, plant a tree. But if you are planning for a lifetime, then develop a man. Training is that important tool through which you can plan for the lifetime. And there are three English letters, A, S, K. A stands for attitude, S for skills, and K for knowledge. Training is a process of imparting knowledge, molding the attitude of people, and sharpening the skills of workforce in any organization. So, today, training is a very, very important tool through which you can enhance the skill, you can sharpen the knowledge, as well as you can change the attitude of people.
How training is differentiated from education and development?
You know that training, education and development, they resemble to each other very much, and there is a lot of overlappings also. But conceptually or theoretically, we can say that certainly training differs from education and development. Let us talk first about the training and education. Training is a specific kind of activity. It is short term, but education is an ongoing process. It's a long term activity. Training is more technical in nature, but education is more general. Education is more concerned with the all round development of individual, but training is, as I already mentioned, training is very specific. It is short term. So, training is having a narrower perspective as compared to education. Education is imparted by the education institutions, but training programs are either organized as in-house training program or by specialized training institutions. And moreover, it is relatively easy to assess the efficacy of training programs, particularly in case of technical training. But in case of education, perhaps it is more complex and difficult to ultimately assess the impact of any educational program. If you compare training with development, again, development is having a more macro perspective, but training is narrower in nature. In fact, being a broader perspective, there are large number of development activities, and training is just a part of it. When we use the term development, then we are more concerned in the organization context, the top management or senior level management. But training is imparted normally either to at the technical level or at the lower level. And again, difficult to assess the impact of developmental programs as compared to training, which is relatively of short term, and you can very well assess that after the training program is over, how that it will be effective by talking about the various techniques of evaluation. Moreover, when we talk in terms of development, then it is the prime responsibility of the individual to ensure his or her own development. But training mode depends upon the kind of training programs and the efficacy of the trainer also. But as already mentioned, that training, education and development, they overlap. There cannot be any watertight compartment among these three terms.
Sir, please throw some light on training need assessment.
It's a very important aspect of training, which is abbreviated as TNA, that is training need assessment. Now the question arises, what is training need assessment? In a very concise manner, I can say that basically training need assessment is equal to performance gaps. Basically, training programs are organized to bridge the performance gaps only, that is, where does a trainee stand and what is the requirement of the organization. Unless the training need is assessed, I'm of the opinion that no program should be organized unless performance gap is there, unless training need is properly assessed. Now, as far as the training need assessment is concerned, I would say that there are a number of methods to assess the training needs. Three kinds of analysis will be of immense use while assessing the training need. Number one, organization analysis. Analyze the organization in terms of its objectives, its goals. Now, besides that, what are the current strength of organization in terms of manpower skills? What are the weaknesses of the organization? So its strength, weaknesses, goals, resources that should be thoroughly analyzed. It will provide you a lot of clues for assessing the training need for the organization. Second kind of analysis can be job analysis. What is the job profile? What are the requirements of the job? Job must be thoroughly analyzed, and on that basis, we would be able to identify that in order to perform the job, what are the requirements? The third important thing is man analysis. The people who are working in an organization, what are their competency level? What are their qualification and experience? What type of skills they are really required? So these three analysis will provide you ample information to assess the training need. And besides that, performance appraisal reports of employees, the various reports and records regarding the performance of work, circulating the questionnaires and conducting the interviews, that is employee survey, is specifically tailored to assess the organizational training need. Feedback from the bosses, interaction with the employees, they are of immense use to assess the training need. And similarly, future training needs can also be assessed by identifying that what will be the future requirement of the organization in terms of the job profiles, and accordingly, training programs should be organized.
So then what factors can be considered while designing in a training program?
Training is an investment, but it is an investment only when training programs are designed very carefully. Now, there are a number of factors that affect the designing of training program. You know that designing is basically developing a blueprint of any training, which is concerned with what, when, how, who, where. Now, when you are designing a training program, then first we'll have to see that what should be the topic of training. On what subject you are organizing the training program, which should be chosen very carefully after thoroughly assessing the need of the organization and need of the participants of the training program. Secondly, who the trainees are, what is their level of operation, what is their experience, how much they already know about that particular training content. What is their requirement? What are their expectations? So assess that trainee thoroughly, and very important part is that who will be the trainers. That's very important, because ultimately training will be delivered by the trainers. So what kind of content they are delivering, and what are their credentials, what is their expertise, that is very important. Training is that important field where no compromise can be done as far as the quality of trainers are concerned. While selecting the trainers, the sole criteria should be their competence and merit. So who are the trainees? Who are the trainers? What is the subject? What will be the duration of the training program? Training is just like a medicine. If you give more medicine than required, what will happen? There will be side effects. And if you are not providing the proper dose, again, it will not be having any effect. So what will be the duration? Then how you are dividing the training sessions? After deciding the training theme, it has to be subdivided into different training sessions. And for each session, how much time should be given? What will be the training methodology? That is also important, which is considered as a factor while designing the training program. Because there cannot be a uniform method of training that is applicable in all the situations. Depending on the training program, we decide the methodology also. Apart from that, in order to have greater efficacy, what kind of training aids would be required for that training program? Maybe visual aids, maybe other kind of aids, that is decided. Then what will be the end outcome of each session? At least we will have to decide also that what will be the end outcome of that training session. So all these aspects are quite important. Apart from that, what will be the venue of training program? What kind of infrastructure would be required? What kind of reading material would be required? Everything should be meticulously designed. That is, training planning should be quite comprehensive, and especially the blueprint of the training program should be perfect. And when in actual the training program is implemented, then this blueprint would be of immense help.
What are the modern training methods which are used by the organizations?
As you know that there are number of methods that can be used to organize a training program. It can be on the job training, it can be off the job training. As far as the on the job training is concerned, there can be number of methods again, like job instruction training method can be there. Similarly, we can rotate the jobs, particularly in case of newly recruited employees. Similarly, when employees perform the job, their bosses can observe their job's performance, and accordingly they can provide the feedback. Similarly, committee assignments can be one of the important method of organizing the on-the-job training programs. As far as the off-the-job training methods are concerned, again, number of methods can be used for that, including lecture method. We can use conferences, seminars as a tool for training. We can organize the management games, particularly for management development programs. We can have the role play. We can impart the training through sensitivity training method, particularly in case of behavioral science training. And nowadays, virtual trainings are quite important, where the employees can be given training through the computers, through internet. And apart from that, various methods can be combined and training programs can be organized. The idea is that whatever training method is used, it must touch the various senses of the employees to ensure the maximum learning of the participants.
Evaluation is very important.
Yes.
This is the last step of each and every process.
Yes, certainly.
So how these training programs can be evaluated?
Let me tell you one thing, that normally when the training programs start, even prior to training program, everyone is so enthusiastic to attend the training program, to organize the training program, those who are involved in management of the training program, everyone will be having so much motivation and zeal. But once the training program is over, whether it is trainer or trainees or organizers, everyone gets so exhausted that they hardly bother about the evaluation of the training program. One thing is very clear, that if any training program is not evaluated, then training program remains incomplete. So, training evaluation is an integral part of the entire training process. Now, the question arises, what is training evaluation? Training evaluation is basically assessing the outcome or efficacy of any training program. Training evaluation is concerned with collecting the information and data about the training program and then measuring it with the objective of the training program to identify that what was thought prior to the training program and now what is the actual outcome. And in a broader context, I would use one acronym, ROTI, ROTI. ROTI means return on training investment. That is really is a matter of concern for every management, that whatever expenditure have been incurred on training program, now after the training function is over, training program completes, then what is the ultimate outcome? How the organization is benefited out of it? Now, as far as the evaluation is concerned, any training program can be evaluated at any level, maybe at the reaction stage. Once the training is delivered, then how the training participants are perceiving it, how they are reacting it, and what is their opinion of the training program. The learning stage, how much the trainees have learned out of the training program, that is very important. Once the training program is over, even after that, if the participants have not learned at all, that is, participants are now the same as far as the learning is concerned, which is prior to training and post-training, then training will not have any effect at all. So, the real outcome is that how much learning is taken place. It is not merely the learning that is important, but more important is that once the trainees return to their workplace, then how much they have been able to apply their learning into the real life situation. If my mindset is the same, if my skills are not utilized, if I am not able to translate my learning into action, then what is the use of training program? So, what is the behavior of the trainee at the job when he is working or she is working on that? Whether he has been able to translate the learning into action or not, that is one of the criteria of evaluating any training program. And finally, what is the ultimate outcome? For example, in any business organization, whether it has increased the sales or the turnover of the organization, whether it has improved the quality of products and services, whether it has reduced absenteeism, or what is the ultimate benefit to the organization in terms of profits? So, at any level, any training program can be evaluated depending upon the perception of the training organizers. They should evaluate it at different level. Now, as far as the methods or techniques of evaluation is concerned, there are a number of methods that can be used. We can use observation method. We can circulate the questionnaire. We can conduct the extensive interviews. We can conduct some examination also. We can use the test group technique also, where we can compare those groups, those who have undergone the training program and those who have not attending the training program. So, what is the visible difference between the two groups? That can be one of the criteria. And we can take the feedback from the immediate bosses of the trainees also. So, again, no one method is universally applied in all the situation, depending upon the, again, the kind of training program, its duration, the nature of training program. We can use number of techniques for evaluation of any training program.
So what factor we'll keep in mind when we are doing training evaluation?
As far as I already mentioned, that the factors are that how much learning has taken place, how much the mindset or attitude we have been able to change. Apart from that, how much skills have been learned by the trainee, how well they can apply their learning into the real life situation. And apart from that, how much the quality of the functioning has improved. That is very important criteria while evaluating any training program. As you know that we use the term entry behavior, exit behavior. There must be visible difference between the entry behavior and exit behavior. If both the behaviors are the same, then it means that training program was not effective at all.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable inputs. Hope our viewers get more insights about training and development. Namaste.